Every day there seems to be breaking news about what AI can do. Earlier this month, there was an AI that they say can code as well as an average programmer, Alpha Code from DeepMind. And then just this week, a study came out showing that humans can find AI-generated faces more trustworthy than the real thing. And tomorrow? Who knows what's coming? AI is better than ever, and it seems to be getting much better than us in fields that used to be our exclusive domain. They've already beaten us in chess and Go. They can also solve a Rubik's Cube faster than any human. They've even written articles and can generate text that looks like it was written by a human. All these feats are quite amazing, especially since computers don't see nor think about the world like we do. While you watch this video visually, you probably have little issue telling me apart from the background. To a computer, though, since the video is just made of ones and zeros, the pixels that represent me in the video look just like the ones that represent anything on the screen. There's no difference. You see, you can tell the difference because of your collective wisdom, what you've learned throughout the years. And this is what all humans are innately capable of doing. This ability is part of what makes our species so powerful. We can synthesize ideas from what we know, and that allows us to deal with whatever problems come up in our lives, including the problem of solving problems, which sometimes can be costly, time-consuming, and subject to human error. That's why I guess someone came up with the idea of delegating some of these problems to computers. But for years, only certain simple problems could be solved by computers through programming. So really, it was still humans solving human problems, with computers just automating everything. That was until modern AI and its subfield machine learning came into play. Machine learning is exactly what it sounds like, machines learning, self-improving computer algorithms. They don't simply do what we tell them to do ad infinitum. They can improve on what they do by themselves. Like with the AI chess program AlphaZero, that started knowing only the rules of the game. It was then trained solely via self-play. At first, it sucked at the game, making random openings and not much sense. But after only 9 hours of training, it was able to beat the best chess-playing entities in the world. And now AlphaZero has its own successor, MuZero, which starts without even knowing the rules of the game. These machine learning algorithms manage to achieve such feats partly due to neural networks. The idea of neural networks comes from the way neurons in our own brains work. Inputs to the neurons are passed on to other neurons and modified. It moves through layer after layer of these neurons until coming out as an end output. These neural networks take advantage of the computer's incredible memory and processing powers. You could watch a movie hundreds of times, but you'd probably be hard-pressed to remember every single scene perfectly. A computer has no trouble storing and going over every single pixel. Not to mention, neural networks are frequently run on supercomputers that have even more memory and power available. But neural networks are just one of the many approaches machine learning employs to achieve such great success in so many applications. There are still numerous others that are at the forefront of research. And with the way things are going, AI is eventually going to win over humans. Not just in the sense of being better than us, but also in the sense of being something we can't help supporting. Just like how smartphones seeped into our lives, it's likely that AI will do the same for much more than we ever expected, such as in health and medicine. One day, you may be served by an AI doctor who knows all of your history and every single detail of your health, including your genes. This AI doctor could live on your phone, computer, or some other electronic device. Because it analyzes data from millions of patients, it could be able to predict what might happen to you based on what has happened to others. With these predictions, it might be able to prevent future illnesses from ever happening, providing you with options to intervene before your medical condition gets worse. But it's not all roses. In the wrong hands, AI can be a weapon that causes impact on a massive scale. As experts have pointed out, powerful AI, if used improperly, can result in individuals being targeted unfavorably. Let's say, a dictator with access to an AI that can predict who might oppose his reign. With such information, the dictator may preemptively get rid of all those individuals. As the adage says, with great power comes great responsibility. But what does that mean to an AI that doesn't understand the concept of responsibility or morality? AI has no notion of good or bad, whereas we humans are both good and bad. In our coexistence with AI, the results are unpredictable. Only time will tell whether it will improve the world or set it ablaze. But one thing is clear, whether AI is the end of the world or our savior, it is a future we must be aware of. AI cannot be ignored, nor is it wise to stand against it. As said by a world-renowned chess grandmaster in an editorial about the AlphaZero chess AI, "I know better than most people what it's like to compete against a machine. Instead of raging against them, it's better if we're all on the same side." And that's it for this video. Thanks for watching, and bye!